Our vision here for Georgetown in Qatar is, of course, first of all, to be globally excellent in teaching and research in whole liberal arts, social science and humanities field. But to be excellent in a way that is not insulated, that rather really ties into society as at large. So in other words, we want to put down roots and link into the rest of society, link into the rest of the academic world here in Qatar and in the region, but also link into other parts of society, contribute, in other words.
Students are highly motivated. We have students who are very strong. They come with international experience, have lived in other countries. You get a wide diversity of backgrounds. I have a Russian with a Lebanese father, a Sudanese with an American mother. I mean, they have all these different international experiences.
What's really key here is that you find diversity also in addition to the student body, you find it in the staff. You find teachers who come from very diverse backgrounds.
We have about 200 students, a little bit more than 200 students. We have about 30 faculty members, you can do the math. It's a very good ratio. So this helps because we don't educate an anonymous group of people. We educate people we actually get to know during the phase of our 4 years with them.
The student body you encounter here is far more diverse than almost any I've come across in anywhere. For instance, at the moment we've got something like 45 nationalities. Overall, since we started here, we've gone through about 50 odd nationalities. And that's an enormous richness that brings an enormous diversity and richness of experience, of cultures, etc. to the student body and to the life of everyone in this community.
I've been following the development of the campus here and just excited about what was going on here. Just to be part of this vision, I guess, you know, really for Qatar and for Georgetown to be extending itself to this part of the world, to be a part of that mission, to be a part of this development of this knowledge economy here. It's just an exciting place to be. So I wanted to have, even if it might be ever so small, to have a little role in that.
I was part of the opening team out here, so it was a very exciting time, a real adventure. I think we were about 17 faculty and staff who came out to set up, and it was a very exciting time. I got to work with our first class of 25 students, and I've seen the university grow and change over the years.
I came here on my own, and that was one of the concerns I had, was thinking as a single woman, how will I be perceived? You know, what will it be like to work with the students, you know, to be in a classroom with students, to be meeting Qataris, and I've been welcomed.
Well, I have to say Georgetown is exceptional in terms of the help, really, truly, and goes out of its way to accommodate anybody. There is very little heartburn from the family perspective.
One, the community here has made it so easy to move here. There's just been wonderful support in terms of housing, in terms of, you know, getting around the city, transportation, you know, just getting used to, you know, how things work here, getting a bank account, a driver's license, you know, just sort of the basics, right? There's amazing support for that in our human resources office. And then that community comes in and you have people, you know, inviting you to dinner, inviting you to meet their families, and you just, you know, so you have this network of people who, at least for me, I felt that they've been looking out for me while I've been here, including the students.
The reason for us to really decide to come here was an excitement for the region. We really wanted to learn what this region is like, what the people are like, what the country has to offer, and in some ways how we can help shaping it. And we have been here now for 5 years, and the changes that we have seen in the last 5 years are amazing, and it gives me goosebumps. You feel there is so much progress going on in a short period of time, that there is some way to be part of it is just really exciting.
It is a much safer place. So my wife and I, we can take a stroll on the Corniche at midnight. This is perfectly fine. My son is very happy here. For him, it's very easy to, he's in a fantastic school, best school we could wish for him. He came here and he was amazed about the international diversity of the students. So for him, it was a fantastic relocation.
The things that I thought would be issues have not turned out to be issues. And so all these things where I thought, you know, as a woman, will I be respected as much in the classroom? Will people be interested in my opinions? Will it be a bit more challenging in the workplace? none of that has borne out.
Doha is a dynamic place to live, and I would say today that the skyline is unrecognizable. So the city has definitely changed a lot since I've lived here. Lots of new hotels, new restaurants, new bars, new events. We have the Tribeca Film Festival now, some really big sporting events that come through town. So I think it's an exciting place to live.
I love photography, and it's part of a very rewarding activity here because you can go out within Qatar, within Doha, and of course in all the travels it's fun to take a camera with you. If my wife wants to go to a gym, we have a gym on in the compound. I play tennis, we have a tennis court on the compound. My son loves the pool, we have a pool on the compound. Probably the most important benefit for us as a family is we have never traveled so much. In the first year alone, we have been in 15 countries. So we have been really using our breaks to hop on a plane, go to a different country, take photos, hike, and explore other cultures. And this is something that we will always remember. If we ever move somewhere else, this is probably the one of the core experiences.
Doha these days is the heart of developments, whether economic or political, diplomatic, in a crucial part of the region. So it's interesting, almost as a laboratory in lots of different ways, to come and live and study and research. But being here as a researcher in any of these walks, any of these areas of the social science and the humanities, is also not just possible, but opens a whole vista of possibility because of the resources that are available here. You know, while much of the world is going through a process of retrenchment, in Qatar, in a very methodical way, the research and development piece of development is being expanded. So resources are targeted to research, and people coming here to undertake research, to pursue an academic career, can tap into that.
I met so many wonderful people, benefited from a great degree, and had a wonderful educational experience here that if anyone's going to ask me if they should come to Georgetown, I would definitely say yes. People sometimes have apprehensions about being part of a community that's still developing, or they have apprehensions about the degree, but I think both have so many virtues. You learn so much just from being part of this development process.